Alright, so, a couple of firsts going on here. You got my first solo backpacking trip, and my first time trying to shoot some video. To make a, some kind of a backpacking trip on YouTube, I'm not exactly sure, but one thing is for sure, there are a lot of fucking bugs out here. So, bug spray is a must. Going out of Icicle Creek Trailhead, somewhere past Leavenworth. I'm way the fuck out here though. It's 45 minutes of dirt road just to get up here, and pretty excited about it. So, first things first, additional to pack the impact. Gotta bring sufficient whiskey. Since I don't have a flask, a water bottle is gonna have to do. Buffalo Trace, being one of my personal favorites, especially for the price point of like 26 bucks. Should be plenty. Maybe a little overkill. This here. All right. Okay, so, a little nervous. I'm 50 feet from the trailhead. Heard something rumble real loud to the right. I stopped to take a look at it thinking it's a deer, and I see a bear staring at me. It's the first bear I've ever seen. I'm a little freaked out. I don't know what to do here. Do I give it a minute? Do I keep going? It's a black bear. I don't think they'll fuck with you. But it's still scary as shit. I'm gonna take a minute and just chill and try to figure out what to do. Because I did drive a long way out here, but I also don't want to die. So, okay, we'll figure something out.
Yeah.
I decided to say, the hell with the backpacking because of the bear that I saw multiple times heading the exact same direction I was heading. And I got my car and drove a couple miles back up the way. Find a place to pull off with a spot to camp. So I guess I'm gonna set up here instead. Yeah. I don't have the most experience being by myself out here, although I've done a lot of camping and hiking. So seeing a bear for the first time by myself, I definitely feel a little bit more comfortable being by the car, and I'm not afraid to say it. Anyway, I guess it's time to set up. I got a spot with some real close trees to put up my tarp, good fire pit, so I think I'll be good to go.
Okay. And setting your line up for your tarp, you go around the tree, pull tight, right? With both your pieces, you have your main end and your working end. Pinch the main end and wrap the working end around three times. One, two, three. After you've done it three times, you know, something looks like that, around just the one piece, wrap it around both. Not tight yet. You need some slack. You can pull a bite in the rope back through, creating a quick release. So when you're done, you can just pull this, it's not an actual knot. The nice thing about this is you can make this as tight as you want, or you need extra slack for some reason, you can loosen it. It's a sliding knot. So if you do this, you have it nice and tight, you can pull your tarp nice and tight. It doesn't go anywhere. It's just sliding tent hitch. Whatever the hell you call it, tarp hitch? I'm not really sure. Super friggin' useful, super easy to do. And lucky for me, oh, as I fall, this tree, which is right next to my tent, is going to be perfect for kindling. All this stuff, this fibrous stuff, should take a spark real easily. So I'm pretty happy about that. So I'm gonna collect some of this and then get going. Okay, so once you get some wood split up, there's some small pieces using the axe. I like to split it down even farther using the knife. It's super easy, super quick. It's nice to have a lanyard, some kind of string. Put your hand through it. You can't slip and run your hand down the side of the blade, which is nice. So basically, just hit it. Twist. Super quick. And you can just process the hell out of this. No time at all. Ah! Nice when your main log doesn't go flying all over the place, but you get the idea. What did that take, all of 2 minutes? Nice.
A few pieces of wood for a base. We can get some coals going real fast. Cook up this steak that I got. Feather sticks, small sticks, bigger sticks. And what I'm hoping will catch a smart in less than fucking 20 minutes of me messing with it. Fingers crossed. Wind's picking up a little. Come on, man. She wants to go. God damn it. Come on, come on, come on, come on. One stick, two stick, red stick, blue stick. Get some of this fat wood on there. Come on, come on. Should do. Wasn't too bad. Okay. So, figure now since I got the tent set up, grab a tarp, get the fire going. I got some wood chopped. Got my skateboard chair and my backrest. I guess I'll take a minute and talk about why I'm out here. You know, I've been coming out into the woods, climbing, hiking, camping for a few years now. And the more I do it, the more I'm hooked on it. And I absolutely love it out here. And I watch all these videos on YouTube of how to do this and how to do that. And all these people doing all this shit out here that I like to do. Finally, my fiance got sick of making, well, no, I got sick of her making fun of me. And she basically said, why don't you get out there and make your own video? Videotape yourself doing shit. So I figured, why not? So I'm out here. Admittedly, first attempt. Not going 100%. Bailed on the backpacking because of the bear. Got a little scared. Came out here and I'm not doing it totally from scratch. I tried to process some of this firewood and some of it was too hard. And I had some in my car, so I chopped that down. But I did start one from scratch using just stuff that's around here. So that's a plus. Now I got a little stick fire going. And once that burns down to coals, I got a nice steak I'm going to throw on that bad boy. Cook up some quinoa. Drink some whiskey. And enjoy it. I got a book with me. Read a little bit. Maybe try and take a couple shots of some stars later. If I can get my shitty gorilla tripod to like hold up straight. Ordered a new one on Amazon. See how it goes. Right now I'm recording all this off my Canon Rebel. And if it seems like something I'm interested in doing, maybe I'll invest in a better camera. An actual video camera. So I can get a little better quality. We move every 3 to 6 months and we hop around and we always end up in these badass places. And figured maybe instead of just taking some pictures, start shooting some video. Learn how to edit it and maybe inspire some people to get out there and do some stuff the way I was inspired by some of the people I watched. So we'll see how it goes. But trip one on the books, finally. So I'm out here just off the side of some dirt road somewhere. I found a pullout. And happened to be a fire pit, so I figured this was the perfect spot. And if for some reason bear comes in the middle of the night, I can run and jump in my fucking car. So that's a plus. Anyway, so far so good, I guess. And interested to see how the steak turns out cooking on the coals, because I've never actually tried that before. I've seen it done a bunch. So I'm very intrigued to give that a shot and see how it goes. Alright, cool. What's that? Oh yeah, that's gonna be nice. So, marinated this thing earlier today. Well, not marinated as much as covered in salt and pepper. This down to just coals. We're just gonna lay it right on here. A couple minutes each side. Let's see how it goes. Oh, mama. Check that out. Oh, yeah. Okay, here goes nothing. Straight on here. Here, get some quinoa going, or some water for some quinoa. Woo. There she goes. That should take long to boil. Not even a cup today. Let's check this out. Oh, it's looking good, guys. It is looking good. Unfortunately, but I do have this big ass piece of wood. This is gonna work as my plate. Get these splinters off. I'm gonna get in me. I don't want splinter food. I'm gonna use most of this with my fingers anyway. I just need somewhere to put it. There she goes.
Tastes good.
It's quite hot enough, but it'll just take a little more time than I want it to.
In the meanwhile, quinoa, wah, wah.
Oh, yeah. Or couscous, quinoa, couscous, one of the two. I think it's couscous. Could be quinoa. Stuff didn't have the most flavor in the world, but it is filling.
Whiskey.
Charcoal never hurt anybody. Oh man. Oh shit, that's good.
I watch all these videos of people cooking on the fire. Every one of them takes a bite. Looks like they're in fucking heaven. Oh, know why? Because this shit is tasty. So much more flavor cooking on charcoal or over a fire in some way, shape, or form. I'm cooking on a show. I haven't had access to a grill in forever because we move around so much, I can't take one with me. Oh my goodness. I wish I had some vegetables to throw in here. Corn or something. Bugs are out though. So tender. A little fatty. I don't generally go for the fattiest cuts of meat, but this one looked good. It's got like a nice little crispiness on the outside. Makes me want to put a fire pit in my yard just to cook food. That's all fat. Oh. Well, I was pretty much done with that anyway. I just catapulted the rest of my steak into the dirt. Well, shit. I guess that's that. Nice.
Okay, so just about 9:30. And I am getting ready for bed. Still decently light out. Even though it doesn't look like it in this video, but I'm fucking whooped. So a couple tips. If you are doing a tarp shelter, you get this. Let's see if I can get this up to where you can see what I'm talking about here. You have your guideline, alright, that goes inside. And you can hang shit from it, which you could slide. One of the things I'm hanging is my water bottle pouch, which is nice because I wake up in the middle of the night and I'm thirsty.
all I have to do is reach up and grab my stuff. I'm good to go. You can either leave that hanging down or tuck it back up. Another thing is if you have a lantern, I don't know what this is going to look like in the video, but you can hang your lantern from that. So, lights up everything. So if I was sitting here reading a book or something, that would be fucking awesome. You know? But I get the fire going. I got everything I need next to the fire. So I got all my wood. Get the actual fire. And I am chilling. So that's about it for me tonight. I think I'm gonna get some shut eye. I'll probably be up about dawn. Because I wake up pretty early as it is anyway. But when I camp, I wake up even earlier. So, and a quick tip. You can see this. I'll turn the light on one more time for you. This right here. Sleeping bag stuff sack. If you have a puppy, put your puppy in your sack. That's the best pillow you are ever going to have. It's a down pillow, guys. Shit is legit as fuck. Alright, well. They said, that's about it for me. Thanks for hanging in this long. See you in the morning, huh?
Bye.
Alright, so it is 4:45 in the morning, and I am wide awake to sleep at. I think we went to sleep around 10:30 or so. So, I mean, I still got 7 hours of sleep, but it's time to get a little fire going, make some breakfast. Okay. Morning. Okay, so you got fire going. Breakfast today. We have oatmeal. Oh. And some coffee. First, eat up some water. And I could just do it in the fire, but ready now. So I'll heat it up on the stove. Hot water. So far, I'm liking this Primus stove. And the valve to turn it up and down works great. Yeah, I should take one minute or two. It wasn't too cold last night. No, it was pretty warm the whole time. A little too warm, actually. I kind of wish it was colder. What do you do? Basically, heating up some water, dumping it straight into my bag of oatmeal. Oh, that way I don't have to clean this thing out. It's just a pain in the butt.
I'm gonna drink my coffee and chill by the fire for a minute, and I'm gonna pack my shit up and get going. Oh yeah, oatmeal pro tip. Trail mix. For sure. Add some crunch, some flavor, and I put a bunch of cinnamon sugar in the oatmeal at a time too. Peanuts, chocolate, all kinds of good shit. Caramel in there. All the small stuff kind of settles to the bottom too. When you're using your oatmeal, you're making oatmeal, is use less water. You take your shit. If you get your bag to stay open, fold it out on itself. And stay open perfect. Basically, just dump it right in. Good. Oh, yeah. Give it a minute. Now what I'm gonna do is make some more water for coffee. Cause I need some coffee. All the goodness in my oatmeal. Oh yeah. And for coffee. Get these Trader Joe's instant coffee packets. There's actually cream and sugar already in them. A lot better than that Taster's Choice bullshit. I hear the Starbucks ones are pretty good, but I haven't tried them. These aren't bad. For a big pot, I'll probably throw two of them in there. But, yeah, I'm looking forward to that. It's not the best coffee I've ever had, but for fucking camp coffee, it's definitely not bad. The nice thing about this is when it's cold and you do this, it's not really that cold right now. This will keep your hands nice and warm.
what you eat. Oh no.
All that chocolate melts down there. Ooh, hear that. That's good stuff. Chocolate for breakfast is always a good idea. Wish I would have had a chair in my car. Oh yeah. Sit this down so I'm not my copy over. That's the nice thing about, you know, a bag. You add all that chocolate and shit in there. If that was in my pot, this would be such a pain in the ass to clean out. You just zip the bag closed. I got my pot for my coffee. Multitasking. Breakfast restaurants. That's a cup of Joe right there. Some bugs land in it. Well, about wraps it up for me. Hope you enjoyed it. If you're watching, I'll probably make some more videos like this. Or some how-tos on some stuff. There are a lot of questions I had when I started out. And videos definitely helped me along. But there's some things people didn't answer, so maybe I'll do some videos on those. Stuff I had to figure out on my own. And I promised to work on my camera angles. Tripod coming soon. Ugh.